For the first doctor, we have three data points. Data point one, well, its observed value is 2.00, and the mean was 2.00. So it's actually a distance of zero from the mean. The absolute deviation of this number, this observation, was zero. What about this guy, 1.2 meters? Well, 1.2 minus 2 is equal to 0.8, negative 0.8. But since I don't really care whether they're overestimating or underestimating, I'm going to always make these numbers positive, which I do by taking the absolute value. So let's just call that positive 0.8. For this third measurement of 2.8, I get again a deviation of 0.8. Now for my three measurements, I have deviations of 0, 0.8, and 0.8. That's the deviation part. What about the average? Well, we know how to do an average. We take the sum, 0 plus 0.8 plus 0.8 gives me 1.6, and we divide by the number of data points, so 1.6 divided by 3 is equal to about 0.53. So the average deviation for this first doctor was 0.53, and that unit there is meters. We can interpret this by saying, when this doctor makes a measurement, I can only say with confidence that she's probably within 0.53 meters. Though even then, that's not always true. In fact, in two of these measurements, she was outside of that range. The way we would write this is by saying, the green-haired doctor measured my height to be 2.00 meters plus or minus 0.53 meters. Now, knowing my height to within half a meter is not so helpful, so let's see what the purple-haired doctor said. Can you tell me how the purple-haired doctor would state my height, including the average and the average deviation? Enter answer here.